junior high school.
We are so pumped for you to come be a part of
Hashtag
Team GCJHS.
We want you to be as comfortable as possible in your transition to the junior high.
We want to show you all the do's and don'ts and the ins and outs of the school, so let's go take a tour.
Yeah, let's go.
Hey, wait, you have toilet paper in your shoe.
Oh. Let's go.
Seventh graders sit in the hall. And then the eighth grader is going to sit in the cafeteria. The bell rings and you'll have 10 minutes to get to your class. You'll get a minute bell warning. When you're in the hall, don't do any horseplay. That will get you in trouble. You can get closed lunch.
I'm Jazzy Johnson, and I teach the crazy cool choir kids.
I'm Mr. Spencer, and I'm the PLTW and Tech Ed teacher.
Hi, welcome to Family and Consumer Science. This is Mrs. Waymeyer.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Strange, and I teach Exploring College and Careers. Welcome to the junior high.
Hi, I'm Mr. Podcar, and I'm the band director, and I also teach MIE, Music and Education.
Hola, my name is Ms. Geringer. I teach 7th grade wellness for all you band and choir students. Get excited.
Mr. Hilton, computers.
Hi, I'm Ms. Gratson, and I teach art.
Betsy Green, I teach 7th grade science.
My name is Mrs. Nagley, and I teach wellness.
This is
D210! I'm Ms. Stinnett, and next year you're going to be learning about geography.
My name is Mrs. Boudreaux, and I teach English.
I'm Mr. Polk, and I teach language arts 7th grade.
Hello, I'm Mrs. New. I teach 7th grade math, 7th grade advanced math, and the tier math class for 7th grade.
Mr. Hacker, language arts.
Hello, I'm Ms. Stewart, and I teach 7th grade math.
Oh, we're rolling. Okay. My name is Mr. Hayworth, and I'm teaching 7th grade world geography, and it's going to be the best class you ever take, or it can be your worst nightmare. It's totally up to you, but looking forward to seeing you next year.
Hi, guys. My name is Mr. Yule, and I teach science. I can't wait to see you in class.
I'm Mrs. Schildmeier, and I teach 7th grade math.
It's cool to be good at math.
Word.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Gravett, and I teach 7th grade, honors in quest science, and 8th grade science.
Hey, I'm Miss Anna Finley, but the kids call me Miss Anna. I teach life skills. See you soon.
This is Miss Stewart, and she teaches social studies.
Welcome to this episode of Greenfield Central Junior High's What Not to Wear. Our guest today is Ronita. As we look at Ronita's outfit, we're going to point out some things that are not acceptable to be worn here at the junior high. First, we're looking at his jeans. His jeans would be acceptable should you have jeans that have holes in them. If you have holes, they have to be from your knee down. If they're knee up, we're going to have to ask you to change your clothes, or we're going to give you a pair of sweatpants. Leggings are permitted to be worn at the junior high if you wear shorts over them, or if you wear a shirt that fully covers your front and your back. Front and back must be covered when leggings are worn. As we look at Ronita's shorts, go ahead and put your hands down at your side, Ronita. They are clearly not acceptable, and she's even trying to bend her arms. So these shorts would not be acceptable here at the junior high. Ronita's shirt is looking pretty acceptable. We're not allowed to wear sleeveless here. So her shirt clearly has sleeves. However, if you look closely, it's see-through. So we actually had to ask Ronita to put a tank top on underneath. Ladies, we need to make sure that there's full coverage. And V-necks are allowed to be worn. We just need to make sure that we cover everything in what we're wearing. And that's been today's version of what not to wear. Welcome to episode 2 of Greenfield Central Junior High's What Not to Wear, male edition. Now, today we have Marty. Marty here is demonstrating some items that would not be acceptable in our current dress code. The first and most important item that Marty here is not following would be his sweatpants. So if he goes ahead and does a little loop for us, clearly our sweatpants need to be fully covering our rear. In this case, that's not happening. So we would ask Marty to pull up his pants. If you can't keep your pants up, then we would send you to the office and they would give you a new pair of pants. Second item, we are not allowed to wear hats or any sort of head covering in school, including beanies and toboggans. We would ask Murdy to remove that item as well. Final thing, Murdy had his hood up. Hoods are not allowed to be worn up in school, so that you are easily identifiable in case an intruder should enter our building. This has been episode 2, male version, of what not to wear.
Lunchtime, woohoo! You will be dismissed by table to get in line. There are 3 line options, giving you multiple choices. Step 1, choose a drink. Step 2, grab a tray and silverware. A la carte costs more money. Step 3, choose your food. No, a tray must have fruit to be a complete meal. Scan fingers and wait for verification and say thank you. You will just be dismissed by microphone.
Please push in your chairs and be patient leaving.
I'ma pick you up in a Cadillac like a gentleman, bring it glamour back, keep it real to real in the way I feel. I could walk you down the aisle. I wanna do you like Michael. I wanna kiss you like Prince. Let's get it on like Marvin, yeah, like Hathaway. Write a song for you like this. You're over my head.
If your parents pick you up or you're a walker, then you need to go to the front of the building. If you ride a bus home, then you need to go to the back. There are first and second round buses. They always park in the same spot every single day. You need to wait on the sidewalk patiently until your bus comes to a complete stop. Then you get on.
See you soon! Bye!
I'm Mr. Jack, the principal.
I'm Mr. Sincroft, the assistant principal.
I'm Mrs. Fortuna, the counselor for students with last names A through K.
And I'm Mrs. Belcher with students with last names L through Z.
If you have any questions, this is the time to ask. We're excited to have you here at GCJHS.